We are really, really appreciative for you showing your support tonight for all the families and the individuals who are facing Alzheimer's. Just to put it in perspective, first of all, let me ask this. How many of you have been touched by Alzheimer's disease? How many of you know or have a loved one, someone you go to church with, someone you live next door to, someone in your neighborhood? Usually when I ask that question, just about every hand goes up these days. And it is a tough, tough disease. So I saw some hands, let's put them up again. If you've been touched by Alzheimer's disease, let's show everyone. Because this is a disease that impacts everybody. And to put it in perspective, as I was saying, you could fill up Neyland Stadium with all the people who are living with Alzheimer's disease in the state of Tennessee. But that wouldn't mean there'd be room for those family members and loved ones who are helping to care for that person. So that's how many people we are talking about. So we sure appreciate the Speedway tonight and Tiny McCarter and her family and all of you stepping up to show your support. And how many of you want to do something about this disease? How many of you want to stop Alzheimer's disease? That's great to hear. I want to invite each and every one of you to come out next Saturday to the Smoky Mountain Alzheimer's Tennessee Walk. This year, it's on World Alzheimer's Day. So we think that's extra special because we want to make a world of difference next Saturday when we walk. It's at Pigeon Forge High School. We get started at about 9 o'clock in the morning. We have all kinds of food and fun for families, and we're even pet friendly. So we hope that you'll come out and join us and look around and see all the other people who are taking steps to stop Alzheimer's disease. And so I just want to thank you again, and I want to thank all the drivers for their show of support with their purple. And I think we have some prizes for the best decorated cars coming up really soon. And again, thank you from Alzheimer's Tennessee. We are here for you. We are here for all those who you know who have been touched by this disease. We do a lot of education, and we do a lot of support. So please find us, call us if you need something or know someone who does. Again, thank you very, very much.
Winning tonight's Thunder and Lightning event, congratulations, in the 44, Chase King. Chase goes back and forth different racetracks. Sometimes he goes other places, fishing or camping or somewhere, but glad to have you back, young man. Talk to us tonight, if you will, about the win, especially those last two laps racing the champion, 42, Robbie Comer.
Well, first of all, I hate that for David Miley. I don't know if I'd ever got around him, but the last couple laps, I tried to set him up a little bit, and I wasn't sure if I was going to get him, so I just went for it. And I don't know what happened there at the finish. I'll let him tell you all that, but I like how it ended up.
Yeah, you got the checkered flag. Let's hear it for tonight's winner, the Thunder and Lightning, the 44 of Chase King. Congratulations, my friend. See you next week. All righty, race fans, God bless you. Godspeed. Be careful driving home. Hope to see you next Saturday night. 50-year-old man, it hurts come down here. So we thought we'd ease on down here a little bit further and chat with tonight's winner, the limited late model, one more time, the 23 of Corey Hedgecock. Congratulations, Corey. A little earlier, I was sort of in humor chatting about him and Ryan elbow to elbow ran through here, taking up money for Alzheimer's. And then lo and behold, what I know that they start on the front row and side by side for 10 laps. But on one of those restarts, about lap 11 or 12, Corey, you checked out. Walk us through the first 10 laps and you and Ryan, and then as you checked out with a pretty comfortable lead and win for the last 20 laps.
Ryan's a real good racer. We never have any problems, real clean, so I was going to run him real clean. Car was working a lot better on the bottom than I thought it was going to work out. I thought it was going to be a train race, but, I mean, actually it was pretty racy. Good job to Mitch and everything for making the racetrack good and everything, but thanks to all my sponsors and Scotty Evans for once again giving me this motor, and all my sponsors from front to rear, too many to name, but most importantly, my mom, dad, Mike, who couldn't be here tonight, girlfriend Katie, everyone who helps. I appreciate every one of y'all.
All righty, Corey, before you go, we're going to visit with this young man down here in just a minute, but you've had one heck of a summer, especially here in the mountain. How many wins, features, does that get for you here in the mountain included? I'm going to say it's close to 10. That's just a wild guess.
No, I think it's either five or six here, but I think we got eight total. So honestly, it's been a great year compared to last year, and yeah, just hopefully we can continue to just keep this thing going on. And appreciate y'all clapping for me.
All right, and one more time, tonight's winner in the Lemonade Model, once again, the 23 of Corey Hedgecock.